Beginning on May 23rd at 2300 local time, a swarm of earthquakes began underneath the Yakedake volcanic complex in Japan. Although earthquakes are relatively common at this volcano, these were occurring at far higher than typical levels, indicating a change in the overall complex. These quakes were almost all centered around the summit lava dome of Yakedake, which has been the site of 26 eruptions since 1905. As a result, the alert level of the Yakedake volcano was raised from green to yellow the following day due to an increased likelihood of volcanic eruption. This carried with it a 1 km exclusion zone around its summit, as previous eruptions have occurred while at this alert level, such as in 1962, which threw large boulders of superheated rock in about the same radius. However, I want to express an additional level of concern that this exclusion zone may not be enough. Although the vast majority of Yakedake's eruptions have occurred on or around its summit, a small explosion could theoretically occur at any location around its edifice which has a fumarole, hot spring, or significant hydrothermal alteration with little or no warning. Although rare, this is exactly what occurred during the volcano's last eruption in 1995, which ejected several thousand cubic meters of rock near a riverbed 3 km southeast of its summit. While there is no indication that a repeat of this event will occur as the temperature of the area's fumaroles are monitored, I would recommend against traveling in the area marked on screen despite it technically not being closed off. The Yakedake volcano is located in central Japan, where it is 30 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Takayama. Yakedake is a stratovolcano which is covered by a prominent andesite to dacite composition lava dome that formed in 350 BC. Carved into this dome are a series of more than a half dozen explosion craters which formed in the last 2300 years. These craters formed through largely phreatic eruptions, which often threw large boulders of rock several hundred meters, flattened trees, and in exceptional cases even generated lahars or landslides. Over the last several thousand years, this complex has only erupted about once every several hundred years. Then, in the 20th century, Yakedake erupted 26 times. The vast majority of these eruptions occurred from three summit craters shown on screen, in between two of which there is now a crater lake. These craters are where the current seismicity is centered, suggesting that if an eruption were to occur, one or more of these three vents would represent a likely eruption site. Such an eruption would largely only affect the immediate summit area and be small in size. However, it is also possible that an eruption could occur several hundred meters outside the summit, much like seen in 1915 and 1962. Those eruptions produced a chain of explosion craters that formed two fissure-like valleys. Due to the ferocity of their associated eruptive episodes and the slope of the mountainside, they generally had voluminous lahars. The large lahar in 1915 killed a large amount of vegetation, but is most notable for damming the Asusagawa River, forming the scenic Taishoke Pond. Although a raised alert level might make it seem like an eruption is inevitable, in all likelihood one will not occur. Magmatic intrusions or a raised volcanic alert level only rarely result in volcanic eruptions between 10 and 20% of the time. In the context of this individual volcano, it has produced earthquake swarms 10 times since 1953, and only twice did this activity eventually result in a volcanic eruption. Although this gives us a figure of 20% for the odds of an eruption in the current situation, I deem the odds to be slightly lower due to the number of quakes which have occurred. But, let's suppose an eruption did occur. There would be an 87% chance that lava would not be erupted and an event would be completely phreatic. Lava dome or lava flow forming eruptions from this volcano are quite rare, with the last such magmatic event occurring 2350 years ago. If a phreatic eruption originated at the peak of Yakedake's summit, the risks of surrounding areas would be low. However, if an eruption occurred at a flank vent, the eruption would be larger and be quite likely to generate damaging lahars, and regional roads would need to be closed off. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. I also wish to give a special thanks to Pontoon for supporting this channel.